What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Uberkooledgarage. On this week's episode, we're going to continue with the bug. The Ghia update stuff is coming. I just don't quite have enough footage yet for a full episode, but I'm still getting work done on it. There's actually quite a bit of good stuff. The car is basically done. I'm just going to go through and polish up the paint and fix any little tiny imperfections in the car. So Ghia stuff is coming. Just need to finish a couple things up and then I'll put out an episode maybe later on this week. But the bug stuff is coming along great. Thank you guys so much for all the likes, comments, everybody that subscribed. If you haven't yet, go ahead and subscribe. Getting close to 500, which is pretty cool. I didn't really expect the videos to get as much feedback as I have been getting, so it's really awesome. Thank you guys for all the support. Hope you guys enjoy this video, and we'll see you at the end. If you guys noticed on the last video, the hood is back on the bug. I have a ratchet strap holding it exactly where it needs to be. I have this bar down here that goes across. As you can see, I have two sliders on it. Went ahead and got those cleaned up. There was these flat plates. I have a flat plate on the inside. That was welded directly to these. So cut those off, cleaned them up so they're all nice and clean. Got this plate all cleaned up as well. And then I have, cut these out of steel. These are 1/8-inch steel plates. Got two of them made. So these are going to get welded onto here. And then we'll get welded onto here. All right, guys, so I got all that tacked in, as you guys saw. So let's go ahead and see what happens. Well, that's good. The hood didn't move at all. Get the strap out of the way. Get this one out of the way. So I have these push pins. That tilts. So that worked out really, really well. Now I can go ahead and start mounting up the radiator and finishing off those welds to make it a little tiny bit stronger. Worked pretty good. Got another package today. I got the rest of the roll cage piping. So two more 8-foot sticks and then of 1 5/8". This one is 1-inch chromoly. This will end up being the upper rear A-arms. So I got my kit from Rhodes Race Car. This comes as an A-arm kit, weld-in A-arm kit. So comes with 2 1-inch chromoly bars, larger sleeve for where the coilovers bolt into. And then it comes with the center heim, the two outer heims, the tabs, and all of the gussets. So you can see here kind of how it sets up. Got your two tabs, heim joint, that, with the chromoly tubes in here. And then this one ends up going back here and tying into both of those to create the A-arm. And then this is the joint there that'll bolt onto the wheel hub. So, got two lowers. I already purchased in the past two of them, so I have the two lowers. These will be the two uppers. I just got to cut and measure and cut these to length and get the other heim joints all set up. But other than that, rear suspension stuff should be pretty close to wrapped up from that. Front suspension's pretty darn close to being wrapped up as well. I just have to finish off the drop spindles. So we're looking pretty good. Let's finish off the cage and start adding in all of our tabs and gussets and all of that. And cage should be pretty darn close to wrapped up. Also went ahead and got the radiator mounted. It's just tacked, welded in for now. So I made these tabs a couple weeks ago. That way I could get this stuff set in. Radiator sits in there nice and tight. It's sitting in an angle because the hood comes down at an angle. So the cool part about this is if I go ahead and pull the radiator out, you can see that my fan shroud stays on the car. So this will get a 16-inch fan cut into it, and that'll stay in the car if I ever have to take out the radiator. Makes it nice and easy. I don't have to pull the fan, the shroud, all of that. So this is got two tabs, one on each side, and then the actual support itself slides into the radiator support on both sides. And then it gets bolted into the bottom of that. So it worked out really, really well. And it is still higher than the lowest point of the car. So I don't have to worry about when I do the front splitter. The front splitter will sit underneath here completely flat. And that flat bottoms the entire car. So the front splitter will be separate from the piece underneath the gas tank. So I'll have a plate that fills in this entire section here that flat bottoms that. The fuel pump and all of that will sit in there. So basically what I'm going to do, start doing all the tabs and everything, all the gussets from the front, and kind of work my way back. That way everything gets situated, and then after I get the majority of the tabs and the actual body can come off, do finish weld on the whole thing, and then paint it, paint the floors, paint the underside of the body, do all that stuff. So we're looking pretty good. We're gonna start definitely jamming along and getting things knocked out here pretty soon, and order more parts, and should be looking pretty darn good. Okay, so I got the top bars in. You guys just saw me tack weld those in. Those are going to be for the coilovers. I also went ahead and tacked in the steering column. There's a sleeve inside there that the bearing slides into, and then that'll get a bolt that keeps the bearing where it needs to be. And then you guys just saw me put the front wheel back on and the A-arms up front. So basically need to get the correct track width on this. So I'll be putting the hood back on, getting it all set where it needs to go, and then I can get the actual track width of the car. If you guys didn't know this, the track width of the car is about 2.5 inches, I believe. I'll get you exact measurements, but it's about 2.5 inches wider than a stock bug. And then the rims are also 8 wides in the front and 10s in the rear. So that's another 2.5, roughly 2.5 inches further on the rim than a stock rim. And then in the rear, it's another, I believe, another 3 inches or 3.5, something like that. So I'll get you guys exact measurements. I'll post a picture here afterwards. That way you guys have a general reference. I've had a lot of questions about the fender flares. See if I'm going to offer them. I am going to offer them. What I'm going to do is I'm going to finish up my kit for them. And then what I'll do from there is I will shrink them down. So I'll probably offer a 2-inch wider in my flare style, and probably a 3-inch wider for stock track width bugs. That way, you know, somebody doesn't have to run a 12-inch wide front tire to kind of compare to how wide my car is. So those will be available at some point in the future. I'm not 100% sure on pricing yet, but once I get that far, I will definitely let you guys know. So once I get the track width set up on this, I can tack weld the A-arm brackets on there, and then I'll go ahead and do the same on the other side. And then I can start adjusting the upper A-arms, get those ones all situated, make tabs for them to connect into this bar down here. So we'll do that. The coilovers fit perfect. I'm going to have to adjust the tabs up top, and I have to make a lower tab on that. But once I get both of these tacked on, then I can start doing the steering stuff, get the steering column in there, and we'll just keep jamming on this. And there's only a couple more roll cage pieces that need to get welded in or tacked in, and then should be able to pull the body off, fully weld the entire cage, make sure all of the tabs are in there, and we should be looking pretty darn good. So we'll keep jamming on this cage. If you guys noticed in the last clip, the radiator was not in there. Had a fitment issue with it, but I went ahead and moved the lower mounts, tilted it more at an angle. It fits underneath the hood now. I have to shave the hood just a little bit to fit over the edge on both sides, which is no big deal. You can see I have the sway bar mocked up. I have all of the suspension mocked up, the coilovers, all of that Everything fits up really, really nice. Also went ahead and mocked up the steering shaft to the rack and pinion. So made this bottom mount. It's just tack welded in there for now. This will end up getting a dimple dyed plate to bring in a little bit more strength, just because this is the main steering support. So need that to be nice and strong. Got a U-joint, shaft, the U-joint, and then the shaft that runs up. I have needle bearings in this section here. So this will get a, went to the store. This will get a jam nut and a stopper. So that'll hold the bearing in there. And then when move up here, right underneath the turn signal thing, there's another bearing up here. So that'll get the same up here. I gotta build some kind of sleeve to cover some of this. This is a quick disconnect steering wheel. So makes it nice and easy. As far as suspension stuff, I have to make new tabs for the bottom A-arms, which will bring it down this bar here. It's loose. So I'll end up moving that up and down and then get the upper A-arms where I need them, the correct angles and all that. So we'll get all that stuff welded in, and then I can mirror it on the other side. Coilovers. I'm probably going to have to make different top mounts for the coilovers. These are just a general reference, just so that I can get an idea where they need to go. The lower A-arm will get a tab for the sway bar link welded onto it. And then it's probably going to have a bar that runs across the bottom of the A-arm with two tabs and probably a dimple dyed plate in there as a gusset, just to get everything all situated underneath. And then we should have front suspension after that. And then we can move on to the rear. All right, guys, so that's all I have for you this week. The front suspension stuff is getting really close. I'm going to go ahead and finish off the front suspension. Just keep working my way back on the chassis, and then starting to look really good. Love how everything's coming together. It is very tight space to put everything. Still have a lot of stuff to go in the front. But it's all coming together really nicely. It's exactly what I had pictured in my head. If you guys have any questions or comments, go ahead and leave those in the comments below. Or you can email me. I'll put my email in the description, or DM me on Instagram as well. So I'll leave that down in the description. So thank you guys for watching, hanging out. We'll see you guys on the next one. Peace out.